over a what? What?
Of course, RB.
Is there an easy way? I know you are trying to get a voltage across this resistor. Then you divide by this resistance, you get a current flowing in this branch. Then the current is equal to this IA plus this IB. Okay? Then you relate your V in with your IB. Is there an easy way? Just now we derive what?
VB alpha.
Just now we derive R in, right? R in is saying what? R in is saying you can replace whatever behind by. Here's your R in prime. Just now we derived this one, right? I in prime. So we already know this I in prime.
So it's VB over R in prime.
So it's actually what? It's actually RB parallel with R in prime. Then plus your R1 is the total resistance for this. This part, right? So total resistance
divided by RB goes to V in over V.
Okay. Make it simpler. Just now we get this VB, right? Just now we derived this VB, right? So we already know this VB value. Okay, what's this VB value?
IB alpha.
Okay?
IB level alpha.
VB equals to IBR pi plus 1 plus beta IBRE1. This is my VB. Okay, this is my VB. So my RN prime? This one, right? And I know this equation, which is VL equals to minus beta IB times RL prime. How can I relate?
So, you can substitute A and factorize the IB.
Okay?
Factorize IB.
Factorize IB. Which equation?
For the VB.
And then? It's your own floor, right? I know VB equals to this guy, so IB will be VB over IN prime. So I can write VB over IN prime times RL prime. So then you must think, how can I replace this VB with something related to my VIN? How is VB and VIN related? VIN, go to this R1. Then separate into two branches. One is RB, one is RN prime. So how to relate this VB with this VIN? If you're going to draw a circuit out, it will look like this, right? And here's my VB.
Vin over R1 plus
carbon plus I prime per gamma.
Can we just use the voltage divider rule? RB and I prime can combine into one resistor, right?
Yeah.
So VB?
VB over RA prime parallel with RB.
VB over VN will be? Then you shift your V in here. You will have VB equals to this one, right? Then you sub your VB here.
You pick up
the V. Yes, then you move your V in to the left hand side. Then you get your V over V in. Question? You don't just look, then, oh, I understand, you really need to go back and practice that. All this equation you can write then, I mean, all this equation, you can write them individually. I think you have no problem with all these equations because they are just Ohm's law, right? You can write them individually. But the most important thing, the skill you should learn is how to relate them together. I have equation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so how can I relate all these equations together? How can I pick up the useful equation and ignore all those not so useful ones? You just pick out the key equation, the useful one, then you just relate them together, you can find whatever quantity you want. So how to learn this relating equation skill, you need to go back and practice. When you do all those questions, you will realize most of them are actually the same.
Is this like for all the six types, all the same, right?
The analysis method is like this. Once you redraw the circuit into the AC equivalent form, you will get something more or less look like this. You have an input, then you have an output. Okay, then you look at the actual circuit, then you decide how to write your own, based on your own flow, how to write all those equations. Because you look at this circuit, you can form a lot of equations, right? But you need to think, what are all those equations that are helpful to helpful for finding my answer? Let's say, for example, now I want to find this the voltage gain. So then you must think, I should use which equation? Like for this case, I may not. Because just now we already find this R in, right? So after you find this R in, you don't really need to go through the VE, whatever VB derivation again. Let's say the